Pandora and will act as your program commentator for this evening's presentation. Tonight's program is presented for the benefit of the Parents Association Scholarship Fund. The concert will feature the Symphony Orchestra, Renaissance Choir, Gospel Choir, and the Symphonic Band. During the performance by each ensemble, the audience is respectfully requested to remain seated, refrain from talking, smoking, drinking, or eating, and help us generate a true concert hall atmosphere. After each ensemble concludes its presentation, there will be a brief intermission, during which you are invited to view the exhibit of student artworks on display in the gallery at the rear of the balcony on the first floor. Luigi Boccherini was an early classical composer who was born in 1743 in Italy and died in 1805 in Spain. Besides being a prolific composer, he was a celebrated cello soloist who toured with much success. His fascinatingly great forceful compositions include 20 symphonies, an opera, an orchestral suite, a cello concerto, 2 octets, 16 sextets, 125 string quintets, 12 piano quintets, 18 quintets for strings and flute, 91 string quartets, 54 string trios, and 42 trio sonatas and duets for violin. The symphony in B flat demonstrates elegant melodies with a good display of wit and energy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Symphony Orchestra, under the direction of Mr. Joseph Rutkowski, will perform the first movement of Symphony in B flat by Luigi Boccherini. Veteran music critic of the New York Times, John Rockwell, called Aaron Copland America's best-known composer of classical music and a gentle yet impassionate champion of American music in every style. Mr. Copland died on December 2, 1990, at the age of 90. Of his many notable achievements, Mr. Copland's greatest gift was his ability to be both serious and popular, to adhere to the formal integrity and moral earnestness of modernism, and also to espouse the generous accessibility of the dominant political mores of the 1930s and 40s. In ballet scores like Billy the Kid, Rodeo, and Appalachian Spring, and in concert pieces like El Salón Mexico, Fanfare for the Common Man, and Lincoln Portrait, Mr. Copland touched a chord in the American psyche reached by no other classical musician this country has produced. Lento Molto is the first movement of two pieces for string orchestra or string quartet composed by Mr. Copland in 1928. The Symphony Orchestra will now perform Lento Molto for string orchestra. This work is programmed in memory of Mr. Copland. in the local news in recent months. The house in which he lived from 1892 to 1895 and composed his famous Symphony from the New World was designated a landmark by the Landmarks Preservation Commission. The house on East 17th Street between 1st and 2nd Avenues is within an earshot of this auditorium. The concerto in B minor for cello and orchestra is the seventh and last work that Dvorak composed during his 3 years sojourn in America. It was also the only work composed during the last year of his stay in America. He dedicated the concerto to his very good friend, Professor Hannes Wilhahn, the best Czech celloist at that time and member of the Bohemian Quartet. Our cello soloist, Trey Lee, has appeared as a concerto soloist with the Juilliard Pre-College Orchestra and as a recitalist at Lincoln Center, the Kosciuszko Foundation, and Steinway Hall. He has been the recipient of many scholarships and prizes, including the Edward John Noble Foundation and Dora Roth Dornfeld Memorial. Treyi was invited to attend the Gregor Piatigorsky Seminar at the University of Southern California and spent last summer in Moscow participating in the 9th International Tchaikovsky Competition. Treyi Lee is a student of Odette Alton and has been a student at the Juilliard Pre-College Division since 1984. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Treyi Lee and the Symphony Orchestra, under the direction of Mr. Rutkowski, will perform the finale movement for Concerto for Cello and Orchestra in B minor by Antonín Dvořák.
Thank you.
There will now be an intermission.